Graham Edmonds. This is a song I wrote called Sorority Girl Vampires.
Hi, my name is Mariam Hassan, and today we'll be getting to know Graham. Graham, could you please introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Graham Edmonds. I'm represented by Aggressive Expression, and I'm an aspiring actor, musician, songwriter, and potentially filmmaker.
So what do you like to do in your spare time?
In my spare time, I watch a ton of movies. I try to watch a movie a day, sometimes two, especially during COVID. And I just absorb everything. You know, I read Wikipedia articles about the actors, about the directors, the editors, you know, people doing the score, whoever it may be. And I just take that and I try to learn from it, and I try to factor it into my own artistic expression and whatever I'm working on. And I also like to run a lot. I think exercise is important, especially for mental health reasons.
So who's your inspiration?
My main inspiration, although I have many, would be Leonardo DiCaprio, because he's been my favorite actor ever since I was a little kid. He's just picks great roles. I think the movie that really solidified that too was The Revenant, because it fully showed his commitment to the role. He's always committed, but in that movie especially, I just remember watching it and thinking, you know, this is real acting, this is real commitment to your art and to your craft. And that I would have been 15 when I saw that, and that really inspired me to look at acting in a whole new way.
So could you describe your acting style?
I would say my acting style is a bit of a combination between when there's room for improv, a little bit of that and stream of consciousness, as well as just really delving into what the script gives you. You know, I think you have to really read into what's on the page, as well as develop some imagination around the character. Think about their arc, their motivations, you know, what would my character do in this scene? Why is my character wanting to do that in this scene? And I think if you can answer those questions, it helps significantly in the realistic element of the acting.
So how would you rehearse a scene if your partner was absent?
Sometimes I'll do this thing where I develop an imaginary confidant kind of character where, you know, especially when doing monologues, when you don't have another scene partner, you can kind of pretend like there's someone else there that you really trust, that's really listening in on what you're saying. And that really helps bring out the emotions and to develop, you know, distinguished emotional beats, I think.
How was it for you writing and directing in your own debut short?
Yeah, so that was a few years ago. When I was in high school, I went to this Tisch summer high school program at NYU, and I wrote and directed and acted in this short called Chromesthesia. It's really about the association between sound and colors. And so I tried to experiment with that. I shot it in Central Park. And it was really cool because trying to think about what it would look like behind the camera as well as being in the front of the camera, just gives you a whole new understanding of the world building that you're trying to accomplish when making a film. So it was a really enriching experience, especially to be made before I got to USC.
So how did you learn to play the guitar? And do you play any other instruments?
I've played guitar since I was in the second grade. It's been a really long time. And there was a long period of time where I didn't play too much. And then I really picked it up in late high school when I got back to college and I started writing songs. And now I've written like 110 songs. Something like that. And it's just a really good emotional outlet for me. So I love playing the guitar, I love singing, I love writing, especially writing lyrics. I like poetry a lot too. I try to look for inspiration from a lot of my favorite lyricists and frontmen of bands like Tom York, Morrissey, Jeff Tweedy, Ian Curtis, and try to incorporate that into my own songwriting. But I play a little piano too, in addition to guitar, in terms of other instruments. Not too well. I'm working on getting better.
And what type of actor do you inspire to become?
An actor who is committed, but doesn't go so far overboard that it's miserable for everyone else. Because I think sometimes you can disappear into a role so far that you forget that, you know, you are playing pretend. You know, that there's an element of imagination to it. And I think that's always important to remember. So I think balancing that with being committed to your craft is crucial.
So what would you like people to remember about you?
That I really love the arts and the entertainment, and that I'm committed to being a sort of conduit for people, you know, and escaping maybe some of the hardships of their own life through art and through entertainment. Growing up, I've been so inspired by actors, musicians, directors, writers, and I want to do the same for other, you know, little kids growing up, because it was so important to me, that creative outlet of watching movies, of listening to music. It gave me an escape when I didn't always feel the best and I didn't always feel the most present. Sorority girl, vampire.